What's up, everybody? Man, it's your boy, Mr. Duga, coming at y'all with another video, man. And today, I'm going to talk about the NFC West, man. And before I get started, I just want to tell the Los Angeles Rams, hello, how y'all doing, man? You know, we got a big showdown coming up, like week 15, where we're going back to the Coliseum, man. And we remember what y'all did to my boy Carson Wentz, man. We remember that, bro. And we look forward to Carson Wentz putting on the show up there in the Coliseum again. And we also look forward to taking over that stadium and having a night home game again, though, bro. But shout out to the Rams, man. You know, we're going to see y'all week 15, man, for what's playing out to be preseason, like before the season started. It's like a huge showdown. But yeah, but I'm going to break down this NFC West, man. You know, you have the Los Angeles Rams, you have the Seattle Seahawks, you have the Arizona Cardinals, and you have the San Francisco 49ers, man. The Los Angeles Rams, they won the NFL Super Bowl offseason, man. You know, they just paid Todd Gurley an extension. You know, they got Ndamukong Suh over there. They traded for Marcus Peters. They traded for Aqib Talib. You know, they traded for Brandon Cooks. You know, I mean, when it comes as far as personnel, man, you know, they got a bunch of players over there, man. You know, Jared Goff out there looking better last year than he did year one. You know, they got the big homie Sean McVay coming in there, man, and just changing up the whole scheme, running an actual solid professional offense, unlike Jeff Fisher does all his career, with the exception of what he had McNair. You know, you got Wade Phillips over there on the defensive end, man. You know, they lost Robert Quinn and they lost Alec Ogletree. And, you know, their offensive line was really good last year, especially adding Andrew Whitworth, man. But I'm going to say this, bro. And I may be wrong, man, but as much talent and pieces that the Rams added, something telling me it ain't gonna work as much as people think it will, man. I mean, I look at the people they signed, man. You know, Sue's still a really good player. But, you know, Aaron Donald over there pissed off, man. For some reason, they want to give everybody money except for him. You know, I don't really, besides like Mark Barron, I don't really know their linebackers like that. You know, Aqib Talib's still really good, man. But Talib, like, he getting a little up there, man. You know what I'm saying? And then you got Marcus Peters, who's a really good opportunistic corner, you know, as far as creating turnovers and stuff like that. But, you know, he's not really a lockdown, shutdown corner. You know what I'm saying? He reminds me more of a talented Asante Samuel type of corner. You know what I'm saying? And they got LaMarcus Joyner, but I don't really know the other safeties like that, man. And the Rams got a tough schedule this year, man. But, like, I mean, they did their thing last year, man. You know, they fell short to Atlanta. They won the division. They won the offseason Super Bowl, man. But I don't know how them pieces going to come together, man. We gonna look out for that. You know, you got the Seattle Seahawks, man. You know, Richard Sherman gone. Cam Chancellor got a neck issue. Earl Thomas trying to get out of that, man. I mean, Earl Thomas trying to get to Dallas so bad, this man damn near walked in the Cowboys locker room after they played last year and told him to come get him, man. So Earl trying to get the hell up out of Seattle one way or another. You know, they still got the big homie Russell Wilson who out there do his thing. You know, Bobby Wagner, man. But like, man, you know, we got Michael Bennett now. They lost a lot of their key pieces, man, to that little run they had, bro. Ever since they threw that ball on the 1 yard line, they ain't never been that dominant team like they was for them couple of years, man. You know, then you got the Arizona Cardinals who got, shout out to Sam Bradford agent, man. Sam Bradford got the best agent in the league, man. I don't know how this man keep getting contracts and keep getting jobs, man. But he over there in Arizona now with Josh Rosen backing him up over there. You know, it's just a matter of time before Josh Rosen take that job. You know, you got the big homie David Johnson coming back, man. David Johnson, something serious. Everybody forgetting about him, man. You know, you got Larry Fitzgerald, man. Shout out to Larry Fitzgerald, man. You know, first ballot Hall of Famer, man. Out there just grinding, bruh. Old like he is, he still get the job done. He still get open, and he still catch everything, man. Defensively, they got Chandler Jones led the league in sacks last year. You know, they got the lockdown corner, Patrick Peterson. They lost the Honey Badger, man. But, you know, we we're going to see what Arizona look like this year. Then you got the San Francisco 49ers, man, who got Jimmy G over there. Never lost a start yet in the NFL, which is crazy. They got Jerick McKinnon over there now, who I guess going to kind of be like the Devontae Freeman was for Shanahan when he was over there, the OC in Atlanta. You know, you got Richard Sherman over there on the defensive end to try to hold on the corner spot. He getting a little up there and is coming off an Achilles, but he's still pretty solid, man. And they got a bunch of young pieces, man, on like the offensive line and the defensive line, man. If Reuben Foster could stay out of trouble, man, they got a really solid linebacker, man. But with that being said, man, I may sound crazy, bruh, but I'm going to go out on a limb, man. I'm going to say the San Francisco 49ers going to win the NFC West, man. I think Jimmy G, Kyle Shanahan, and them young players going to get it done, man. I think the Rams finish second because for some reason, I don't think they do as good as people think, man. I got the Arizona Cardinals finishing third. I got the Seattle Seahawks finishing last, man. I just think their time has come. Their time is gone. You know, they're just waiting for the next wave of talent to put around Russell Wilson. So I got the San Francisco 49ers winning the NFC West, the Los Angeles Rams second, the Arizona Cardinals third, and Seattle Seahawks fourth, man. With that being said, man, y'all like and subscribe, man.